What's up, you guys? So I just got done seeing the new Apple event. I'm trying to take this dog on a walk, but she just wants to chill in the grass. So so here we are. This is a little vlog for the day. Just want to talk about the Apple event that I just watched. Sorry if I'm looking here. I'm looking at myself. I need to be looking in the camera. I haven't like vlogged in a while, so bear with me.
What is that? Why are you? What are you doing? Are you chilling?
All right. It's funny. When I first was watching it, I was like, you know, there's already so many different Amazon Echo and stuff like that coming out. But the features that got me was the ability to have one HomePod Mini talk to the other HomePod Mini in the home. The HomePod Mini being able to identify different voices, I thought that was pretty cool. And I'm already in the Apple ecosystem. So it kind of makes sense to have a smart home with my iPhone, with my iMac, with my MacBook, with my iPad. It just kind of makes sense. Typical Apple guy. Then the iPhone 12s came out. Right, and I was just looking like, they took out the camera. We have three cameras, right, with the iPhone 11 Pro Max. It's like, oh man, they took out the camera. Now they took out the charger. Now there's no headphones. I thought they could put some AirPods in there. That'd be pretty cool, but they didn't. But then they revealed the iPhone 12 Pro Max with the 10-bit HDR video recording in 4K, the Dolby Vision video editing in the phone and filming in the phone. That's pretty fire. As somebody who does video full-time, that's gonna be really interesting to incorporate the iPhone in, you know, some of the videography stuff that I do. That's pretty neat. So I was definitely like, I don't need it. I got the 11 Pro Max, I'm good. But now, take my money. Just take my money. Do you guys think you're gonna get the iPhone 12 Pro Max, the iPhone 12, the iPhone Pro? Do you guys think you're gonna get a HomePod Mini? Let me know in the comments below. I did think that they were gonna come out with the Apple Silicone, like iMac or something in this, but I guess that's in the future, so I guess we'll see how that goes. Now, I made a post the other day saying I miss the days when Apple made releases that were substantially different than one another, not just one every year. But it seems like they are working on the technology super fast, and they're still putting out good stuff. So I mean, kudos, get the money, but they're pushing out new stuff. I do like that they're saying the glass is more durable. I do like that it has the XDR display, the same display as a really expensive monitor that you can have as a secondary monitor from your computer if you wanted to, or your primary monitor if you had, you know, like a tower or something. I also noticed they were pushing 5G really heavy, which is interesting because I've heard a lot of like negative things about 5G, about like the radiation, how it can infect the environment. So I'm really curious because they're doing things to rid the environment of like any type of toxins or bad materials or things that would negatively affect the atmosphere. So I'm really curious about the 5G advancements that they've made with the phones. I thought it was really interesting they had the Verizon guy up there talking, and I was like, oh man, Sprint's probably pushing the air right now. Like, oh, where are we at, bruh? We're not on this. But yeah, so I've heard a lot of negativity about 5G, and so I was really, it was really interesting seeing that Apple saying, we're cutting out the camera and we're cutting out the charger because we want to save the environment. And then it's like, but 5G? I don't know. So if you have any information on 5G technology, comment below. Like, I would really like to know what you guys have heard about 5G, because I've heard negative things. So that's really interesting that they were pushing 5G so heavy. But other than that, I think I liked everything that they were pushing about the iPhone 12 Pro Max personally, for the things that I would use it for. It's crazy how technology, how we have advanced. So when people are like, oh my God, that phone is so expensive. But you know, we use our phone for more than just a phone call. It's your computer, it's your calculator, it's your camera, it's your like phone, obviously. And it's the thing people use for games. People use it as like a device to locate things. People use it for their banking information. It's like crazy, which also has me thinking, I use Apple Pay more than I even use my debit card. Are we moving towards a society where we just use technology to pay for things? There's no more physical bills. Have you ever been to a gas station or like a food place and they say they're out of coins? Like, dun, 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 nah. Just a thought, man. It's interesting. Like, you use your phone for so much these days. So that makes sense why they're so expensive. You know, I mean, if you want a cheapo phone, there's plenty out there. But if you utilize your phone for your day-to-day activities and use it for a lot of productive things, more than just a phone, I'd recommend Apple. Side note, I'm on a little walk today. I don't know if you have, but I've been working from home. And I know it's COVID-19, but I put on the COVID-19 pounds since I've been working from home. Holy moly. I need to lose some weight and stop drinking and eating what I shouldn't. You know what I mean? So, as we all should. It doesn't help that like they just built a Chick-fil-A like right down the road, and I love Chick-fil-A. Anyways, you guys have a wonderful day. Take it easy.